Some people fast for religious reasons or medical reasons, but isn't not eating for a long time kind of dangerous? Bom dia, Earthlings. Thanks for stopping by DNews. I'm Trace. The holy month of Ramadan is wrapping up this week, and those Muslims who've been fasting for 15 hours a day or more will be able to enjoy food anytime once again. It's not just Muslims who fast. Christians, Jews, Confucians, Hindus, and other religions have followed the practice for thousands of years. Non-religious folks fast too, usually for medical or dietary reasons. For some people, the idea of abstaining from food while the sun is in the sky is unfathomable, and they might feel that it's even unsafe. So science is here to demystify some fasting myths. A person is considered to be fasting if they've abstained from a meal for 8 to 12 hours. So if you think about it, most people fast every night and then break their fast in the morning. That's where the term breakfast comes from. Fasting is a completely normal part of being an animal on the planet Earth. Many organisms eat only once a day, or less, especially those eating high-calorie foods like meats. Cold-blooded carnivores like snakes can go days between meals, whereas warm-blooded carnivores like wolves or coyotes, they hunt daily. Like the coyote, humans are built to be able to fast for a short period. A day or so isn't going to hurt you, and some studies have shown that short-term fasts can actually extend lifespan. They can boost immunity and mental function, and so on and so forth. We did a whole video about that last Ramadan, so check it out. A study published last month in Cell Stem Cell found that fasting 2 to 4 days at a time can cause a reduction in white blood cells, which sounds bad, but it's actually a good thing. See, the cells that are killed off are the older or damaged immune cells. And when the body rebounds, it uses stem cells to create brand new, healthy ones. Long-term fasting, on the other hand, is a whole other beast. When humans fast, our bodies go through a very predictable schedule. Our bodies are great at squirreling away energy in the forms of fats and sugars, but like coyotes, ideally we would eat every day or so to replenish those reserves. After 24 to 48 hours of fasting, the glycogen reserves stored in our liver and muscles, basically carbohydrates, are empty. After 2 days, the body's figured out that it needs to feed on itself and is gonna start breaking down muscle and fat tissues. Obviously, water is important too. 72 hours without water is dangerous. So while straight food fasting isn't so bad for you in a short burst, 72 hours without water is the beginning of medical dehydration. So drink water no matter what. Some of you might already be yahooing to get the lowdown on a fasting diet, but the problem is humans don't really work that way. When you fast, you lose a few pounds right away, but that's mainly liquid weight, and it will be replaced as soon as you eat again, which is another thing. Researchers at Cornell asked college students to fast for 18 hours, and then offered them a buffet-style meal, not unlike iftar, or the community meal after sundown during Ramadan. The most popular foods were those that were high in calories, carbs, and starches, because our cells don't know if we're ever gonna eat again. Therefore, they turn on the cravings for carbs and fats, which might fend off long-term starvation, but that's silly. You know you're gonna eat again. So don't listen to your reptilian brain. Ideally, a human coming off of a fast would eat vegetables and fruits. Lean meats and maybe a few carbs can be part of the meal too, but not a big part. Ultimately, fasting puts stress on the systems of your body, but low-level stress that isn't gonna hurt you. And it might build up the systems, like similar to how exercise builds muscles. Fasting isn't dangerous or deadly as long as it's done properly and in partnership with a healthy diet and exercise. If you decide to go on a fast, let us know why and how you've done it. You know, because we're curious. You can fill us in on your journey in the comments or send us a tweet at DNews or me at Trace Dominguez. Speaking of journeys, if you want to know how MSL Curiosity got to Mars and what the heck it's doing up there, come to our space out on July 30th at 4 p.m. Pacific. We are getting experts from NASA JPL who actually work with the rover on Mars every sol. That's Martian for day. See? Learning already. Get over there and RSVP. Thanks for watching DNews, everybody, and please subscribe.